I will start by just gluing the front on this cover. Oh, I need to ink it up. I'm always forgetting that, especially when I'm doing videos. And I'm talking to you guys, I'm having a bit of a hard time focusing sometimes on the crafting as well. And English isn't my first language either, so I really need to think about everything I say, and then I need to think about what I'm doing as well. I watched this channel, what was it called? Oh, I don't want to say it wrong now. I think it was Tilt and Tethered. It's a Polish girl, I believe. A Polish woman. And I love her channel. But she mentioned in a video the same thing, that she found it quite challenging to talk in English and craft at the same time and create a good video. Yes, and then also the pressure of making it enjoyable to watch and not long enough and all the editing that goes into it. It's quite, it takes quite some work. But yeah, if you have suggestions for me of how you want the video, how long you want the videos to be, or if you like something to see more or anything like that, you can always leave a comment. And I'm not sure, and I of course can't promise anything. If I also need to keep to what I like doing myself, of course. So otherwise, it wouldn't be enjoyable to do. But I am enjoying it. I'm just sometimes it's like now. For example, I'm thinking about crafting so much that I forget to talk. Okay, let's get rid of all these air bubbles. Okay, and there is some air inside the envelope because when I cut this down, by the way, I wanted to tell you, I just put a strip of glue here and glued it together, and I will sew around it later so it won't open. But and I also glued the flap down that normally opens up like this. I glued it down. But there is some air inside the envelope because I didn't glue all the way in it. But I don't mind that, because that actually creates a good cover that is sturdy and a bit moldable as well. So I love envelopes as covers, actually. I use it more often. And you can paint over them, you can put fabric or paper, you can do a lot with envelopes. You can make entire journals out of envelopes, actually. I might do that someday. So we put that down, and I need to continue on. Let's see. I was thinking I would use this paper on the back, I think, because I used that one on here, and I want to mix it up a bit. Although I love this, and I will probably do it on the other one again. I need to get rid of those edges first. Did I ink it up? Oh yes, I did. Oh, already forgotten what I just did. Okay. Let's just get rid of these light edges. Okay. And then I need to measure how large it needs to be. So I want a bit on here as well. Like you see here, I just put a strip of it down here and then I continued it on the back. I need to think, do I want this part? Because let's see how it looks with this. Or I could also use the other side, I think. Or would it be upside down? Or I just cut it down like this. I think I want to use the other side because it has a bit more yellow and a bit more contrast. And I don't want it to blend in too much with this part. So I need about, I'll just use a pencil to mark down how much I need, and then I will cut it inside my pencil mark. So you need to keep in mind that when you put your pencil mark down, that you want to cut inside of it, because otherwise you see the pencil mark. And then let's leave that here, because we need to, let's see if this fits. Yes, that's nice. And then I need to think about what to put here. So I can't continue the image this time on the back, because I cut down that side, and otherwise it would be upside down. And there's some text here, so although I don't think it's very obvious that it would be upside down, but I like it this way, I think. Or I might use that side. I think I like this side more with the yellow. Okay, I need to put down my pencil mark again. Like that. Oh, and I obviously don't mind seeing a bit of the brown envelope. I actually like that. So that's why, oh, I didn't cut that small enough. I need to cut off a bit more. And it didn't cut straight as either. Oh, I ruined the paper. I tried to cut off a tiny bit, and my paper cutter doesn't always take that. Okay, and I haven't printed out extra paper. Okay, I might try to salvage it. Let's see if I can cut off. I don't want. Okay, I need to use my scissors, I guess. Let's see. It's not very straight at all. I need to cut off more here. When you're junk journaling, you're constantly making mistakes. even when you've been doing it for a while, it just happens. But it's more about how you fix them, because you can always fix them. You can always put something over it or glue something down when it's not perfect, because it isn't meant to be perfect, actually. It started out as something that was much more junk than journal, if you could say that, and now it has become this like perfect art form sometimes, and it can make you feel like you're not able to do it, but try not to compare yourself with others too much, because it's more about the process and about enjoying creating. And I could print it out again, but that would be a bit wasteful anyway, so I think I will just glue it down and you won't be able to see it afterwards. And I will sew around it as well, so I don't think anyone will notice so much. Let's glue it down. I want to glue this part first. To put it in the middle. Okay. Oh, that's lovely. I like that. It's quite different, isn't it, from this one? Just by using different pictures and papers. Just using my book pages here to glue this. Just make sure that I glue down this side first, and then that way you hardly see the tear. And I put it upside down. I think I put it upside down after all. Oh. Okay, well, I put it upside down. I've noticed now the lettering partly goes this way and partly goes the other way. So I guess it doesn't really matter, but I like the color, this color on that. I think I might try to pull it off, but I don't know if it's... Maybe it's stuck down. I'm really stubborn like this. just left it. Okay. I need to cut this a bit. Okay. Now I need to glue it again and put it the other way. I was just mentioning how I didn't want it to be upside down, and then I put it upside down. If I would have used another glue, this wouldn't have worked. But luckily, this glue is not that fast drying. Let's see. You can. No, it's not straight. Just need to put it. Oh, there's a lot of air bubbles now. This is giving me a hard time, this paper. I just need some extra glue on here. There's quite some air bubbles, but it'll turn out okay, I think. Whew. Okay, that was a bit of a challenge. Let's see, this one is for this one, and I want to cover the inside with a paper by Roxy Creation. I think this one. I have this one as well, but I think this will be pretty with the other. Let's see, this other, the other signature. Yes. Okay. So we need to cut this down as well. And then I need to see. See, I think doesn't really matter which side is which. I think with this one, just seeing what I like more, and this dark edge, I think I like it more with the on the front. I'm going to put it like this, and then you can see this paper doesn't reach far enough for me to glue it down in its entirety. So what I did here and with this journal was, well, I can show you how it looks. I cut it down and I just put it towards the middle, and you can see a bit of the brown edge where the signature is, but mostly it's covered. So is this the same inside? No, it's a bit different. Okay, so I need to put my pencil mark down where the crease is. And then I have one side, and I could actually put it this way if I wanted to. I think I like that more. Yes. And then the other side. I'll put this way. Kind of just a little strip of this one. Let's hope that it doesn't tear this time. It does. Well, maybe my blade isn't sharp enough anymore. This is so frustrating. I think I will just use my knife for this, because I don't want to destroy the paper again. That's right, about right. Ink them up. Okay. I just love these papers by Roxy Creation. They came out a bit orangey when I printed them out. In the computer they were a bit more brown. Like when I would do my own tea dyeing, but I don't mind it actually. I love it because now I can still use my own tea dye papers alongside with these, and I just love the patterns she did. I'm not really able to do that. I don't have the fabrics for it, but I also haven't really figured out how to make these patterns with tea dye and coffee dye. I think you would do it in layers, like one tea dyed layer and then let it dry and then add another with the fabric. Something like that. I wanted it this way. Let's do it right this time. Yes. Okay. Glue down the corners like this one. Take it off. Glue there. This needs better gluing. Okay, I like that a lot. So this, the reason why I put Roxy Creations paper here on the inside is because I like the contrast with the blue. Otherwise it would be very blue, 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 blue. So now the outside is blue. But if you look inside, but all the tags and the pockets will make it even more blue. So I feel like that contrast is really needed here. So yes, I could sew it around it, and I'm going to, but first I want to make a pocket here and a belly band here, because I like it when my pocket and belly band is actually sewn in and not just glued. So by making them first and gluing them down first, I can sew. The sewing will grab the pocket and the belly band and make them more secure. And I didn't cover this, by the way. And I just, yeah, I liked the peak of brown there, because so I could have put a strip down there as well, like I did on this side. But I don't mind seeing a bit of the brown envelope left, and having a peek of what it used to be. Okay, so for the pocket and the belly band, I already cut down a strip of brown paper that matches the brown of the envelope for the belly band. And I did use quite a wide strip. So maybe normally when I make a belly band I would make it like 3 centimeters, and now it's a bit over 4. No, it's 4. So because I want to use one of these round pictures in the kit on the belly band, like I did here. The belly band needed to be a bit wider, otherwise it would have looked a bit funny, because the circles are quite large. But I loved how it turned out on that one, so I'm doing the same here. And I put these pictures on a bit of brown paper as well, just to give it a bit more strength. So I'm cutting that out now. I don't know which one I want to use actually. I'm just cutting out this owl, but I have to see which I like more with this journal. The other one will go in the other one, in the other journal. So I think that one has, just seen, this one has a deer on the back and this one an owl. And I also had these envelopes already printed out that can go in the back. So it's like this in the kit, and then I just fold an envelope and I printed another paper on the other side so that this wouldn't be white. But I have one with a deer and one with the birds, same as in the other journal, because there were only 2 types of envelopes in the kit. But I'm thinking now that the deer will go with this journal probably, because there's already a lot of deer in that one. So the birds will go here, and then I have to decide if I want a squirrel or an owl. I think I want a squirrel in this one, and the owl, and owl in that one. Just have to decide these things, because I'm making 2 journals and I don't want them to be exactly the same. It's just more fun for me to switch it up a little. So some things I have to print out 2 or 3 times to put in these journals. Because some things need to be in every journal, like the pockets. But other things I might just choose to put one type of envelope in this journal and the other type in the other journal. Things like that. Maybe this needs to be glued down a bit better. Here. That's just very tiny part that is coming off. And then I need to ink this. Let's ink them both. So I did collage this part of the belly band. So I'm doing that again. Because I have some scraps. By using the kit, you always create scraps like this. And I'm not throwing anything out because I can use these kind of scraps on here. I like to have some music paper as well. Let's see. Did I use a straight edge? Yeah, I did. Okay. I'm just going to do the same here. Let's just do something like this. Oh, it's the other way around. Okay, so just this way. Just take the piece off. I'm just creating pieces that might fit. I like some of this as well. If I put it under the other pieces, the tear line will go over this. So I think I like it. It's just peeking through. Maybe I will tear a bit. No, it won't come up. Tear a bit more of this music paper so that you can see the other paper a bit more. Yes. And then this will go here. That, I think. Is there a bit of that as well? Okay, and then this will be in the middle, of course. And we need something here. I think I will just continue that or we have something else. Like just this. No, it's a bit too similar to the background. The straw paper? No. Yes. I think I might use some graph paper. I need to cut it around here. And then it. This will be my background here, I think. A bit of light in there. Don't mind that. Yes. Okay. So now I need to ink up a lot of these pieces. I need to tear this. I don't need to ink up this side because the other side will cover it. I'll just put this piece down first. And I'm leaving a bit of a border around it, like I did everywhere. So you can see a bit of the brown paper. I think I'll put this down next. And there's a child screaming outside. Don't know if you can hear that. Am I using the right? Yes. I was wondering if I'm using the right sponge. Okay. It's becoming a bit messy here. On my table. Okay, let's see, I think the music paper was next. Or maybe I did want this edge to go over. Well, it doesn't really matter. Just need to ink this up. Paper is getting quite sticky. I like this part to go under here, I think. And I want it to go over. No, I want it to go over the music paper. I'll glue this down, and then I'll glue this down. Okay, so doesn't quite. Okay, there's a piece of brown there, but I think this will cover it. Yes, so that's all right. Okay, I like that. Let's see, I will measure the middle. I could eyeball it, of course, but I want to be a bit precise with these journals. I'm just putting a mark where the middle is, and then I'm going to glue blue, I think. So that's it. I want it to be a bit more secure than just the glue stick. What I can do is just mark how large the circle is. So this is the middle. So here's my pencil mark for the middle. So I'm just putting the middle of the circle here, and then just putting the mark here and there. So now I know where to put my glue. And I'm putting my glue on the belly band instead of this, because there will be a bit overlapping. If my glue wants to come out, there it is. So I'm just doing a circle here. A bit over my pencil marks. And I'm just going to place, I don't know if you see this, I'm going to place this about in the middle. I'm a bit eyeballing this because it's a bit impossible to measure. And I'm just going to look at the other side and see how much overhangs both sides, so I know it is it's in the middle. And here I'm just looking if the picture is straight. I think this is fine. And I need to wipe off the excess glue here so it doesn't glue down to my page or cover, I must say. Okay. Oh, that's very cute, that squirrel. I like it. Okay, so I'm gonna let this dry for a bit, and I will work on the pocket here. And what I did for the pocket was I took one of these postcard pictures from the kit. So there was the fox, and then these birds, and the rabbit, and the owl. So I need to pick two more for the other two journals that I want to do. I think because the birds are already on the envelope of one of the two journals, that's exactly the same picture. So I think I won't use the birch, and I want to use, yes, I think I will use the rabbit and the owls. Although it doesn't really matter, because in this journal we will put the other envelope in of the deer. So we might use the birch. I think I will just look at what I like. How about that? I'll just see which one I like with which. This one is for. I'm getting a bit confused sometimes with all these journals. Okay. So, I like the owls, the birds. So we won't do the birds in this one. I like the owls. So there was an owl on the front here, I think. I lost the piece that would go on the front of that one. I'm not sure where it went. I think it was the owl. Oh, here it is. Yes, it was the owl. And then, yes, I think I like the owl's hair. And I will, okay, so I will, where's my scissors? Okay, I will just cut this down. No, I will use my cutter. This, because I need to be a bit, I want it to be straight. Okay, I'll just take the two owls and put them with that journal so I remember that I want to put the owls in that journal. And then I need to choose. So I'll just put this together. And then I need to choose what to put in this one. So I can do the birds or the rabbits. I like the birds, I think. I do like the rabbits, but somehow I find it, I don't really like it with this picture. Yes, we'll go with the birch. I need to cut these out. So the reason why I'm cutting out two, and I printed out two of the same picture, is because I want to create a pocket with it, like this one. I need to put it in the background, and I need to one more to create the pocket, and then it will continue in the background. You can't really see it very well here with the fox, because the picture of the fox is entirely on the pocket part. But the picture of the birds will be on this side, so this will be a bit different. Let's see. So I need to tear out a part, but it needs to be in the left corner. So I'm just going to tear I just don't need to look at it. I just need to tear out. It's a bit smaller than the other one, but it doesn't matter. So the picture will continue on the background. And then what I did here was put a bit of a brown paper behind it to make it a bit more sturdy. And I left that showing a bit. And I also need to put this on a brown paper. I already cut that earlier. So I need to ink this. Now I will glue that part down. So this is the first pocket, and then it will be a double pocket. But I need some brown paper for that. I think I had a piece left here. Yes. Just going to glue it on. And I will leave a border here as well. the same same width, and then I'll cut this piece off, and now I'm going to tear around this, which is a bit tricky. Also, I don't want to tear into my image, but I also don't want it to be too... I have sticky fingers. I also don't want it to be too wide. My fingers are really... I need a new wet wipe. Tore off some there, but okay, it'll look like this. I want it to be tear off a bit more, I think. Well, that's going to be very hard to do. Maybe I shouldn't try that. I need to ink the border. I don't think I inked around this part. No. Okay. So now all I have to do is glue this down. It's a bit warping a bit. And I'm just using a really just using a bit of tacky glue on the side here. That's way too much. Okay. I'm just taking some off. Because you don't want the glue to get everywhere. Because that way the pocket won't be usable. This is just a very small pocket. More of a tuck. Lining it up with the larger pockets. I can use this picture somewhere else. Okay, I like that. So I will use a little bit of glue to hold this in place, and then I will sew around everything. But I think I might lay this on under a book to flatten out a bit first, because when I would glue it in now, I could glue it down and then it will probably hold its shape better. Yes, and I will glue the belly bands in place as well and measure the middle here. And then I will sew around everything. So I won't sew the signature in yet, because I want to. I might want to do some sewing on the pages still with the machine. Yes. So I think that's it for today. And I will show you next time how I sewed everything. And then we will continue with the pockets. But I'm loving this project. And I need to do this one as well. And I will probably do this one off camera. And I can show you that as well. So I will see you next time. Please subscribe if you haven't already. And like this video. Leave a comment if you want. And I will see you next time. Bye.